reasons to doubt, try to keep me down, but I'll put the flame out, you can't get to me.
Well, so I know you guys are waiting to hear the news about Sword Art Online Season 3, and all they really did was reconfirm it. But there is something that really, basically, I feel personally, gives us a release date, because when working on a project, they usually skip about a season. On average, they skip one season, and that season would be fall and winter, most likely, since, you know, fall hasn't truly started yet, but more, you know, more so than not, I would say they're skipping winter. But if you really want to get technical about this, they are skipping two seasons. And what am I getting at here? I'm getting at the simple fact that Sword Art Online has been worked on. Season 3 has began to be worked on, and that's something that's really exciting to see, because just knowing that it's in progress, you know, it's making the progress to become the full anime adaptation is huge. And what that means to me is it's coming out next year 100%. It's begun being worked on. As you can even go check out on someone like Fox's Anime, he will even say the same thing if you guys don't believe my credibility. So another thing that's really huge that's going on, Sword Art Online actually announced in a spinoff. An anime spinoff, not just like a manga, not just like a light novel spinoff. They have announced an anime spinoff of GGO, and that's something I'm really excited for and interesting to see. I will say the main antagonist that, or at least the people who seem to be the main antagonist of this show that's going to be the, you know, GGO spinoff, they seem really like cool characters. They seem like characters I can get along with, I can like, you know, I like their character designs. But my big issue is with the, you know, the protagonist anime designs, from at least what I think in or view to be the protagonist anime designs. And you got, I'll probably leave links, if I don't, remind me to leave the links down in the description below of the visuals. But nonetheless, I'm not a big fan of the protagonist anime designs. Those will be the characters in the front. And if they were going to make a spinoff, actually, you know, I would not mind if they wanted to do the SEO progressive. And yes, guys, you will see I got my 4th and 5th volume. The progressive reviews are coming. And I may split those up, the books, in, you know, up in between chapters this time. But that's really besides the point. Let's get back on the main topic here at hand. So what do you guys think of this? The GGO spinoff. I know a lot of you guys are probably like, whoa, GGO spinoff? When's that coming? I don't know. I would assume either before and or after, you know, Sword Art Online. And I'm wondering how many episodes is the spinoff going to be? Is it going to be 12? Is it going to be 25? And it really makes me wonder, why a spinoff of GGO? Why not do like maybe an SAO progressive spinoff of retelling the story and with more detail? I don't know. I'm interested in that. I want to know more about this. I want to know how that idea came to be. So other than that, guys, I'm probably gonna end the video right here. I also got an index anime I need to talk about that I haven't seen, but you guys will like it. Anyone who's a fan of anime should like that video. But other than that, guys, you guys have been Hex. Be sure to leave a like, comment, subscribe, follow me on Twitter at Hex25. See you guys next time. Be sure to check out my Patreon down below if you guys want to help me out here on the channel, because it really does help. And I'll see you guys next time. Peace. Thanks for watching, guys.